There are a couple goals we want to think about in terms of type 2 diabetes, and one of them is laboratory values. In both cases, with type 1 and type 2 diabetes, we want the LDL or the bad cholesterol to be under 100. And in some cases, doctors will suggest or want their patients to get a level of 70 or less on the bad cholesterol. We want the good cholesterol to be over 45. We want the fasting blood sugars in general to be between 80 and 120, and the two-hour readings under 140. But those patients who can get in the normal range will be even doing better. So we generally recommend someone who just has slightly high blood sugars to try to get their blood sugar in the normal range, which is 80 to 100 fasting, and between 80 and 120 within 2 hours of a meal. Probably the most important number when we look at how well someone's doing is the hemoglobin A1C. And that's the number that tells us how well someone is controlled or has been controlled over the last 3 months. And so we generally recommend that a person with type 1 has a hemoglobin A1C that is less than 7%, and for type 2, we generally want them to be as close to normal as possible, under 6%. What's really positive about type 2 diabetes is that in many cases, one can go into remission. And that means that there's no evidence of the diabetes anymore in terms of lab work, blood sugar checks, or symptoms. And so the ultimate goal of someone with type 2 diabetes is to put their type 2 diabetes in remission. And the principal way to do that is for them to continue to work on their diet and their exercise regimen to make sure that their blood sugars are staying normal. Now, if someone does come to that point where they're in remission and they decide to go back to some old habits, the diabetes can come back. So it's not a cure, it is a form of remission.